Hello guys and welcome to my craft desk. Tatiana is here with you today with a fun balloon card. Creating this project, I used only one stamp set. It's new balloon numbers stamp from Sugar Pea Designs. To start, I die cut a bunch of small balloons using the coordinating balloon numbers sugar cut. I'm using my ever favorite Strathmore Bristol paper and VersaFine Onyx Black ink since it's crisp and waterproof. When I'm working with the coordinating dies, I prefer to make my die cutting first and then go with stamping. I usually take my Misty and stamp the first impression on a piece of a scratch paper and then align the negative part of the die and pop the positive die cut inside. There are three reasons why I like to make die cutting before stamping. First of all, because it makes super easy to make multiple stamping, like I did with the first balloon. I had to align only once the negative part and then could quickly switch the positive pieces and stamp. The second reason is that when I use VersaFine Onyx Black ink, it's a pigment crisp black ink and works fine for stamping, but it remains wet for a while. In spite of I let it air dry well in the past, I finished to have the ink transferred to the cutting plate of my die cutting machine and finished to ruin other projects I did afterwards by transferring the ink on the paper. Last but not least, this method allows me to center my images perfectly and makes the stamping process super easy and relaxing. Because once the positive cut is aligned inside the negative one, it's super easy to stamp twice on the same spot and have a perfect impression. I let the VersaFine ink air dry well, and now I'm switching to the coloring. Today I chose to play with my Tombow markers. I'm also using a small water brush from Pentel, since it makes the blending process super smooth and easy. To start, I did the initial layer of color and let the images air dry for a while. Next, I'm coming with more strong colors and making a little bit of shading. If you have troubles with blending when you work with your watercolor markers, you can scribble some color on a piece of a clear acetate on an acrylic block and then use your water brush to pick the color. This way, the blending will go much smoother. Once finished with coloring, I proceeded to work on the background. First of all, I took a piece of scratch paper and fussy cut a cloud shape. Next, I'm taking tumbled glass and peacock feathers distress inked along with a blending brush and blend some ink from the top of the cloud shape to form my background. I'm switching back to the balloon numbers stamp set and taking a piece of a black cardstock. I'm covering it with an anti-static powder first, since I'm going to make some heat embossing. I'm using VersaMark ink this time. It's a clear stick ink and works perfect for heat embossing. To start, I stamped, covered with the embossing powder and heat embossed the banner shape first and next added Hooray Sentiment inside. Next, I placed my balloon cluster on top of my background and make little marks with a pencil so that I could add some balloon strings on the right spots. Finally, I could assemble all the elements together by popping the cloudy background on a foam tape and next adding balloon cluster on top. I've added a few extra balloons from both right and left sides and finishing with the banner sentiment. That's all for today. Thanks so much for stopping by and have a great day.